Illustrator's superpower is that it can create infinitely scalable artwork that can fit on something as big as a billboard or as small as a postcard. But how's that even possible? You might be thinking, I've tried to make photos bigger and they just end up looking like this. Well, in this lesson, we're going to explain exactly why that's happening and the secret behind Illustrator's magic. But before you get into the tutorial and your practice, let's explore what makes Illustrator amazing. To understand why images look what we call pixelated, it's important to understand what a photo is made of. Recognize this painting? Probably not. It's just a bunch of colors. What about now? Impressionist paintings like this one use short brush strokes of color, combined in just the right way to create something our mind can understand. And photos work in the same way. You've probably heard the term pixel before, like a 12 megapixel camera. Well, a pixel is just a tiny dot of color. And these tiny colored pixels combine together to create a photo. So that 12 megapixel image of your friends you've got on your phone, it's really just millions of tiny pixels. So why do photos look pixelated if you try making them too big? Well, pixels are actually square. So the bigger the image gets, the bigger the squares get. If they get too big, we're back to looking at an impressionist painting. So where does Illustrator fit into all this? Well, when we create artwork in Illustrator, we're not creating images using a bunch of colored pixels. We're using an entirely different method. This method is called vector art, and it's the secret behind Illustrator's superpower. Now, you may not have ever heard of vector art, but I guarantee you've been creating vector art for years. You just haven't realized it. Think about your favorite presentation software. Have you ever made a shape? A text box? If you have, then you already know the basics of how to create and use vector art. Take a look at these two shapes. The one on the left was made in your favorite presentation software, and the one on the right was made in Illustrator. But notice how I can select and move both shapes. I can fill them both with color and change the outline. And most importantly, I can make them as big as I want and never have to worry about pixelization. See, you've been creating vector art this whole time and didn't even know it. In Illustrator, you can use vector art in much more complex ways to create designs that would never be possible in that other software. In this orientation series, you'll learn what you need to get a jump start in Illustrator and begin creating your own graphics, illustrations, and more. Now it's your turn. Start this tutorial with step-by-step instructions to explore some vector art and see this all in action.